Hello everyone. Hope you are safe at your home, and we are back with another episode of Interview with Inspiration. This is a small initiative that is taken from Skill Rediscovery. Skill Rediscovery is basically Asia's biggest skill-based platform. I'm working as a public relation officer at Skill Rediscovery. As our today's guest is Ms. Dinesh Yadav sir. He's serving as head of department at animation. With Asian Academy of Film and Television. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you so much, Piyush.
Yes, sir. So before starting this discussion, I would love to know about your journey. How it begin? How you enter in the animation field?
My journey was not so easy, actually. Like my parents, just like a typical parent, they don't want me to go for this animation kind of thing because they don't know what is animation is. So just like everyone, they wanted me to be a doctor. So, but after this after my graduation, I did my graduation from biology, BSc biology. And after that, I was not having so much of, job opportunities. Like I joined in a pharma company and I was working for 1 or 2 months. After some time, I realized that this is not the thing which I wanted in my life. So just selling some medicine on 10-20% commission, I was not happy with the job. So after that, I quit the job. And then I realized that why should I do something which I love to? Like, I was very fond of reading comics. I was very fond of watching cartoons and movies, that kind of thing. So, I joined an institute, Edit Institute of Multimedia. At that time, I was in Jaipur. So, I did 1 year diploma from there because that time BSc was not there. So, I did the diploma program of 1 year. And I started my journey from there. And that was not very easy. My parents was not happy that what is this animation? Still, you are behaving like a child. You are making cartoons, this kind of thing. So anyways, but and after that, I went to Mumbai. After sometimes I went to Mumbai. From Mumbai, I did one more course from Arena. And after that, I joined Asian Academy of Film and Television itself, where I'm working right now. I was a student there in 2006. Prior to that also, I was doing some jobs. So from 2002, I started my journey in animation. And I have worked in ad agencies. I have worked in event management companies. I have worked in animation, media. Almost all kind of industry I have worked, and from last 8 years I'm serving in training industry. So I have given services to various universities also. Prior to that I was in Bangladesh and I was working there as master trainer with the government department. So there also I was into training, so I was giving training to people across the Bangladesh in 15 to 20 universities, and there I trained around 20,000 students with my team.
Wow.
In 4 years. So it was a small journey. I started animation.
I think, sir, the topic or the initiative we started, Interview with Inspiration, it defines a lot. As your journey started as a pharma company and you entered in the animation, it was really a good story that can inspire lots future coming students. With that, I'd love to know what challenges you have faced in a more in technical field, like if you are working as a animation industry. So what challenges you have faced as a technical, like parents issues and the family issue? This is the more you can say, but in a technical way, what you issue you have faced from the animation industry?
Yes. In animation industry, there are a lot of issues. Actually, see, when you watch a cartoon movie, for 2 minutes of animation movie, you watch it and you laugh. But to prepare that 2 minutes movie, we spend around 2 to 3 days more, even more sometimes. So to make this, actually, the major issue is that there is no time. There is no fixed time. Sometimes burden is too much. In India, there are few animation series like Chota Bheem and three more episodes are there. But in other countries, there are a lot of 2D animation series and animation films are there, mostly. So when they are working, like schedules are so tight, like in 1 week, you have to give 5 episodes. To make that 5 episodes, how much you have to work? So people are sitting in the office for next 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, they don't know because they have to fill up the target. So this is very difficult. Another thing, when you are working in that kind of atmosphere, then food. You will not get proper nutrition. What, like in my, whatever experience I am having, we were keeping that Maggie pouches in our pockets. And when most of the time we used to give him, Dada, it's Maggie branches, so he used to prepare and give it to us. So that kind of nutrition, then again, when you have this screen, every time you are watching the screen long time, pain in your eyes. Okay, yes. You are sitting in a wrong posture. So then this backache and neck pain, that is also very common thing. That. So apart from that, people sometimes, my colleagues went into depression. What is this kind of job? Continuously they are making paintings and recheck again. You have to work properly. No, client is not happy with this. Again, you have to work. So, and the major issue is that competition.
Yes.
Like in this, when I started my journey, there was only few people who know animation. Okay. But nowadays, every 6 months, in every 6 months or 3 months, students are coming out from the institutes. Some are coming with the certificates, some are coming with diplomas and degrees, everything. So you have to compete with them. I started, there were different softwares. Nowadays, the different softwares are completely different. They are working, the industry is completely changed. So you have to be updated. If you are not updated, then the person is coming with 3 months diploma, he will take you. Okay. So you have to, if I say that I'm having 15 years of experience and I want this much of salary. So he said that you are working, there is one person, he has 1 year diploma and he is not having that kind of experience, but he is ready to work in 15,000 rupees. And he is also working in the same software. So you should have something to justify your salary or remuneration. Okay. So you have to keep updating the main issue, because a lot of competitors are there and you have to compete.
Industry is getting more and more developed as the students, yes, are coming in this industry. Nice.
Yes, and even with the new technologies, they know some new technologies, new software which you don't know. So you have to be updated according to the industry.
Yes, so
there are several things you have to in this, there are very challenges. So these kind of challenges, and another thing like payment, when you are into this kind of competition, then pay scale is also,
yes,
if you have the project, like I said that I am going to charge this much, he said that another person is charging 50%, what to do? Then if you are okay with this, then okay, otherwise another person is ready to take the charge. So it happens with me several times.
Okay. So yeah, as you explained, sir, you are working in this head of department of animation where you also study. So I would love to know what type of courses does the university and your department offer to a student if they're starting in their career?
Mm-hmm. At AAFC University, we have course structures from script to screen. And we are not only giving courses in animation, we are giving courses to cinema also, camera also, audio video editing, sound design, performing arts, dance, music, animation, everything, which is very much required to make a movie, to make an animation film. Okay. So we have programs like a diploma in animation, so 1 year program, and a BSc in animation for 3 years degree program, and we have one master's degree also in animation. So we have designed the curriculum according to the industry standards. Like every after every 1 year, you can say the technology changes. Okay. And you have to modify your courses, but in between it's not possible to change immediately. So after some time, 3 or 4 years, we used to change, we used to revise. So we have an expert team. The people are working into industry, so they suggest us that these kind of technology and these kind of things is presently we are working on. The industry is working on these kind of things. So we used to incorporate all these things into our curriculum. Then we have a BOS, people are from different industries are giving their suggestions, searching for some loopholes, and that is how we have designed the course. And in AFC, we are giving them practical training, like we are teaching how to use camera. So in animation, we have virtual camera, but along with that virtual camera, we used to give them real camera, so that they can have better sense of understanding how lens work, what is focal length.
Yes. Okay. Different. So basically, you are also giving there the new technology, and you are also focusing on basics, so they can be also. Okay, sir. Nice. So I would love to know what is the current scenario of animation. What you are thinking? Like there are many new cartoons also there. And the people also working, like I think I'm currently recently launched the new Tom and Jerry movie. I have seen that. So time is getting more and more, and the industry is also getting more. So what's your viewpoint on current situation on animation and VFX?
The scope of animation is very good. The scope is very good, but the scope is good, but the major reasons, I don't know whether you have heard the news that Blue Sky is closed. Last week, there was a big studio, Blue Sky, which Ice Age movies you have seen. So this studio was the creator of that movie. So they have closed. So there are several animation studios, they have closed in few years. Reason, there can be several reasons. It's very difficult to survive, and it's very difficult to sustain with animation. Like in India, we are watching animation movies, but mostly the movies are coming from abroad, Hollywood or from other countries. Mostly Japanese animation industry is on top. If you talk about the animation industry, Japanese are on the top. But due to this competition, they are also facing the same issues. Challenges are everywhere.
Yes.
Yeah, but in this pandemic situation, this corona situation also give boost to animation. Like I still remember the day when it was announced the complete lockdown in India, and the same day I got an offer to make three small 2D animation films for a marketing company. They want their product, like they were unable to sell, to do marketing normally. So they told me to create a 2D animation clip so that they can forward it on WhatsApp group to their clients and to do marketing. So still I'm getting those kind of work. 2D animation, motion graphics, 3D animation. And yesterday only I completed one task I have from one of my clients in Denmark. So because if you are unable to do the things like in the normal way, physically, digital media is the only thing which can help you.
Yes, sir.
So challenges are also there. There are only few people, handful of people who can do properly, professionally animation. There are a lot of people who knows animation, but I'm talking about the professional thing. Okay. So for that, we have a lot of scope. But if you talk about normal things, yes, we have a lot of competition and you have to face the challenges. If you and this is again the same thing, survival of the fittest.
Yes. I would also know that if we can talk in a layman language, like I am a student who currently completed my 12th. Okay, I have a lot of interest in animation VFX. Advice you should give to that type of student who are currently moving to animation or jo willingly start karna chahte hain apna career animation or VFX mein?
Okay, animation and VFX industry ke liye koi special, you don't require any special qualification. Whatever you require, only creativity. Okay. Agar aapke creativity hai, you can do it anytime. Okay. If you see ek do saal ka bachcha hota hai, aap usse pencil pakda do, wo kya karega, wo pencil leke diwar pe draw karna shuru kar dega. Creativity is inside already. I'm the facilitator. मैं सिर्फ उसका हाथ पकड़ के ढंग से ड्रॉ करना सिखा दूँ. Okay. So creativity is a thing which you cannot purchase from market. This is with you. So you have to identify. Like मैं भी कॉमिक्स बहुत पढ़ता था, वो बहुत देखता था, मूवीज, कार्टून मूवीज, एवरीथिंग. So what I did, I simply I converted my hobby into my career. Okay. तो अगर आपकी हॉबी है तो आप तो ज्यादा अच्छे से कर पाओगे. मैं मेडिकल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव बन के एरिया मैनेजर बन जाता, ब्रांच मैनेजर बन जाता, बट शायद मुझे वो खुशी नहीं होती जितना खुशी मुझे अब है. यस, मैं वही काम कर रहा हूँ जो मैं बचपन से करता जा रहा हूँ. तो आई एम इंजॉइंग माई जॉब, आई एम नॉट डूइंग जॉब, आई एम इंजॉइंग माई हॉबी. तो इफ यू हैव द क्रिएटिविटी यू कैन गो. यस, बट एक चीज आपको हमेशा ध्यान रखनी है कि एनिमेशन इज नॉट एन ईजी टास्क. पेशेंस. If you do not have the patience, you can't do anything. Like students are coming, तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं क्लास के अंदर उनको पेपर पे बनाना है शीट. Like we have one more people from there, start from scratch. पेपर पे आपको जीरो बनाना है, बनाइए सर्कल. तो दो तीन चार दिन तक सर्कल ही बनाते रहते हैं वो. सर वी आर हेयर टू लर्न एनिमेशन एंड यू आर गिविंग अस अ पेपर एंड टू ड्रॉ सर्कल. सर व्हेन वी विल स्टार्ट द एनिमेशन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट थिंग. इफ यू कांट make anything, sir, it's a 4 days, sir. Sir, have patience. You have 3 years. So agar patience nahi hai, now what students start, they used to go on YouTube on some different things, so they get confused. So trust is very much important. Trust on your trainers. Okay, like if you have enrolled for this course, so have patience na. You have your facilitator, you have your trainer, and he will guide you properly. So if you have that kind of thing, no one can stop you. You will be successful.
Yes, as you mentioned that for animation we do not need any type of skill, we just have to be a creative. So this creative thing also focused by our PM after launching the new education policy. So what's your view on that new education policy?
Yes, in the new education policy, our PM has mainly focused on skill training. Okay, skilled education. Like we have the, and if you talk to personally, I appreciate the new education policy. It was very much required. After 34 years, they have changed the overall view of the system. So more or less they have focused on skill training. Skill training means if you talk about 20 to 30 years ago, a person who is the 10th pass and he was like, I can do any kind of job. 10th pass, 10th pass ho gaya, abhi to ye kuch bhi kar sakta hai. After some time a period came like graduation, BA kar liya, so koi bhi competition exam mein jayega, sab jayega. Any kind of job, कुछ नहीं पता, history, political, whatever subject, it doesn't matter, only marks count.
Yes,
and
sir.
Even I don't know whether he still remember कि हल्दी घाटी का युद्ध कब हुआ था, but I don't know. ठीक है, ही स्कोर्ड अ गुड मार्क्स एंड नोबडी रिमेंबर द मार्क्स इवन. आफ्टर सम टाइम व्हेन कंप्यूटर्स वर लॉन्च, कंप्यूटर जिसको आता है उसको बहुत अच्छी नौकरी मिल रही है. उससे पहले टाइपिंग आ गया था, टाइपिंग आता है गवर्नमेंट जॉब, कंप्यूटर आ गया गवर्नमेंट जॉब, फिर एमबीए का ट्रेंड शुरू हुआ, देन एमसी का ट्रेंड शुरू हुआ. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स वर कंटिन्यूअसली गोइंग ऑन. सो फ्रॉम दिस एमसीए एटलीस्ट यू हैव अ स्किल्ड नॉलेज. ओके, सो नाउडेज ही वाज मोस्टली फोकसिंग ऑन स्किल. लाइक देयर आर सम students who are not good in in no, formal education. मैं भी ऐसा ही, मुझे भी ज्यादा पढ़ाई समझ में नहीं आती थी, बट आई हैव समथिंग एक्स्ट्रा कि आई कैन डू मच बेटर इन दिस फील्ड. सो व्हाई वी शुड नॉट गिव हिम दैट काइंड ऑफ पर्टिकुलर ट्रेनिंग, वो उससे ज्यादा अच्छे से कर सकता है. एंड इफ यू रीड द पॉलिसी, उस पर जो पूरा फोकस्ड है दैट इज कम्प्लीटली ऑन डिजिटल ऑल्सो. लाइक अगर आप स्किल ट्रेनिंग देंगे ड्यू टू दिस कोरोना पेंडेमिक ऑल्सो, उनको जो पढ़ाने का जो वे है दैट इज ऑल्सो डिजिटलाइज. ओके, तो इवन स्टूडेंट्स को भी हम जो पढ़ाते हैं अभी, अब शुरू हुआ है कुछ टाइम पहले, लाइक देर आर सम सीडी अलोंग विद द बुक. सो इफ स्टूडेंट्स डोंट वांट टू रीड द बुक, दे कैन यूज दैट सीडी, पुट इट इन द लैपटॉप और ड्राइव एंड यू कैन सी एनिमेटेड और मोशन ग्राफिक्स एंड दे कैन ईजली remember, they can easily understand the thing. So that kind of thing they have promoted, and it's a very good initiative because the coming the future is digital, completely digital.
So yes sir, so basically if student is not interested in study, so they can also give more better, because I don't think so. When I was in 12th, there are many students who are just focusing on marks. I didn't know who the they have know the formula of oxygen for the H2SO4, but we just are focusing on marks. So I also think that the new education policy help a lot of students who are more creative, like you and me. So we are more focusing on creativeness. What do you think upon the Indian fraternity of education that affected by COVID? That I think the most important or most field that get affected is education in this COVID.
So see, the education industry is very much affected by this, because mostly the trainers are habitual of giving training face to face.
Yes, sir.
And here, and my students are in front of me, and I can easily, so eye contact is very much important in most of, in some classes. Like if you're talking about body language behavior, eye contact is very much important, which is enabled here, not possible. So those who have understand the requirements of the future, they adopted themselves, they are working, and again, survival of the fittest. And yes, if you cannot adopt the present scenario, they are out of the industry. Okay, like there are several trainers who are who don't have too much of technical knowledge, like what is computer, how to operate computer, they don't know. But they said that now we have to do this, and within 1 month they got training, and now they are conducting online classes. So they are still working and they are enjoying. Yes, we have learned a new thing. And there are many people who said, no, this is not possible. No, we can't do this. So they're out now. They have to search for something else. Okay. Because nowadays, the mode of communication, mode of teaching is also completely depending on digital platform.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Even all the students are using YouTube. And nowadays, the technology is moving very fast. The kids are still using mobile phone, Android, laptop. They understand each and everything. So you have to use this digital platform also, okay? Because this pandemic has already taught us so many lessons. Now the contents, now the books are converting into digital content. It can be through animation, it can be through any other tool, but this is going to be digital very soon. And it's happening now. One or two people, my friends have got assignment from some government department that they have books and they have to convert these books into animation. From now onwards, everybody is moving on. So what they will do, they will give them tutorials kind of things, or they will record the lecture and they will share. So that kind of activities are now everywhere. You will very soon you will see these kind of activities everywhere. So you have to adopt this culture, and if you cannot adopt it, then you have to maybe you will be out of the task.
Yes. So, this e-education and e-learning is getting more and more. So, what yes. you think, what are, you can say, a tutor perspective, did you feel that it will be get more better for as a tutor? Basically, I'm not saying as a student, but as a tutor, what do you think? You should love in teaching the student at classroom or in the form of interview, like we are doing that in a Zoom call. Do you love to do that, or you are more comfortable in classroom?
See, being a trainer, like in my industry, it doesn't matter for me, because I was preparing content for e-learning. If I am preparing the content for e-learning, then I am habitual of applying it also. From around 5 years ago, I was conducting the classes from Bangalore to Hyderabad, corporate training I was doing. Okay. So from that time, I came to know that this is going to be the future. And you, and because I was doing the training many years ago, people have started just recently, last year only. So both the process have their own significance. Like if you are sitting front to front, like face to face, that is good because you have eye contact. Students want to ask something and they can easily raise question and I can answer. That is okay, good. In digital mode, sometimes we have to check for the connection, and sometimes it's getting diverted. Okay, sometimes you are in flow and some suddenly. Your due to internet connection, the class starts. So it happens. Okay. So and apart from that, some students are using tutorials on the YouTube universities. Also, there we have everything you can get. But what personally I feel, to get that kind of knowledge, first you need to clear the base. The importance of a physical trainer. Not physical means the importance of a trainer who is teaching you, that is very much important. Because when I started my education, I was also getting trained by a trainer, and after that I used YouTube and I learned so many softwares according to the industry. Because when I learned, there was only four softwares. Now there are 15 softwares. So if I'm working in 15 softwares, I have learned from YouTube only. So in my opinion, first you have to create a base, and that base can be given by your trainer. And after that, you can go with any mode, digital, YouTube, from anywhere you can get the source. Industry is very big, and nowadays everything you are getting on, digitally you are getting everything available. Yes, because sir. I'm also preparing e-content, I'm uploading on internet, and everybody is accessing. So that's it.
जैसे बेसिकली जो इंटरेक्टिव सेशंस होते हैं और एक ई लर्निंग सेशंस होते हैं जो रिकॉर्डेड होते हैं, सो एक ट्यूटर के पर्सपेक्टिव से और एक स्टूडेंट के पर्सपेक्टिव से अगर देखे जाए तो व्हाट डू यू थिंक कि कौन सा बेटर होता है दोनों में से? सो इनमें से दोनों से कौन सा बेटर होता है कि स्टूडेंट कौन से में ज्यादा इम्पैक्टफुली लर्न कर पाता है?
इन माय एक्सपीरियंस, व्हाटएवर आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड, द स्टूडेंट्स आर मोर interested in interactive session. Okay. Like my industry is different from, and there are some management trainees are also there. It can be different, but in my experience, in my subject, because I have seen, like in few corporate companies, they have assigned me a project in which they have, they want some interactive quizzes. Like if you want to get appraisal, so the HR wants me to prepare a quiz, quiz section or some interactive activity, which is very much required. So they are going to put everything in a game session, gamification kind of thing. So we prepare and we give it to the employees. You have four chances And this, it seems like they are playing the game, but actually they are fighting for their appraisal. Okay, that kind of thing. So they are very much interested. Both are having significant, important significances in few courses, like in management or some other classes. They use some recorded session also. It depends, course to course. But whatever I have seen, like from primary to playgroup to master to PhD college level, now everybody is enjoying that that kind of interactive sessions, interacting e-learning projects. So this is my personal opinion. Interactive sessions are more impactful, and this is more impactful also because what we because we enjoy the activity and we learn more.
So basically, yes, I also moved toward more interactive sessions. But like the new policies that PM has announced, so they are focused on more skill. So I love to know you that your opinion on what you see the skill education based education, like more education focused on skill in India. What you see upon that?
Skill development, I think 7 or 8 years ago, I was into skill development program. Okay. And after 3 years, after 2-3 years, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana arrived. So in that section, what we were doing, like there are several students, they could not study. They could not study. Why? Not of financial issues. They are very, they are from very financially strong family, but they don't want that kind of thing, like me. Okay, so they want some technical skills, and there are several people, mostly the people there, they cannot afford that kind of education or whatever, and there are few majority of the people who are well educated, but they do not have any job. So what to do? We have to prepare that kind of skill set so that they can go for direct job. Okay, it's a skill based employment means in a very short time you are going to learn something and you are ready for job and you start earning. Okay, so in this program also they have initiated the same thing. Now in this plan, what he has done, students are going to learn through digital mode. Now the trainers also have to be shifted to digital platform. So those who are not comfortable with the digital mode, they have to take training. Okay, so because for that, now we need that kind of infrastructure also. Internet connectivity should be also there. So the government is working on infrastructure also, because like from last 1 year, we have observed that in my class, if I say 40% to 60% students can attend my class, and apart from that, those who are into rural background, they are unable to attend the class due to anything. They do not have connectivity, they do not have laptop also, and if the internet is there, it's very much expensive. They can attend only 1 or 2 classes and not more than that. So government is already working on that to provide the cheap subsidized data pack. And they have to work on to provide tablets or these kind of electronic items, gadgets, to the students so that they can attend the classes. Apart from that, TTT, we call it Train the Trainer program. Like the teachers who are going to teach the students, they need training first. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So the person who is giving the training, he has to be trained first. Okay. So like I'm into the animation field. Okay, I have prepared a quiz on e-learning platform. There are several buttons. So first, he need to understand how to give training, because this is adult training. The person to whom he is giving training, they are not kids, they are adults. So adult training is different from student kids training. Okay, so they should be trained. So there are several things which needs to be developed, and very soon I hope it will be done. And because I said nowadays we are giving training on VR and AR also. virtual reality, augmented reality. We are preparing applications. We are preparing applications, put you on your mobile phone and put you into your gadget, wear it, and you can work. So, and this is the future. If you talk about the future, digital future, our Prime Minister is completely focusing on future, and the future is into VR, virtual reality, augmented reality, robotics, artificial intelligence. This is the future of IT technology. Everything is depending on these things. So those who are not comfortable with these technologies, they have to be. If they want to be in the system, they have to adopt this culture. And one more challenge is that, like in India mostly, we do not give mobile smartphones to kids, or you can say females. Like if I have a daughter, I have son. Son is using mobile phone, but I do not give it to my daughter. Okay, so we have to change the system also. We have to treat them equally, because if she is not having smartphone, how can she attend the class? And how she can utilize all these digital contents? She is still using that 1500 rupees or button wala phone. So she is not able to attend the okay. So there are several places where we have to do this development. But I'm pretty sure that within next 4 or 5 years, this will be on the ground, and everybody will enjoy this digital platform. The corona has taught us several things.
Yes, sir. They have taught us that how you can stay home and enjoy your life. The main thing is that, sir.
We are enjoying now we are habitual of it.
Yes, sir. We are habitual of this lifestyle.
Yes, because when you say that I cannot attend the class, the first class, online class, my school says how to attend the class, I don't know. Now they say, sir, let's have a meeting, sir.
Yes, sir.
Share the Zoom link. Because they are habitual. Even I'm getting calls from somewhere, you do not have to go anywhere. Let's meet on Skype or Zoom or anywhere. So we are habitual on it, and very soon it will be everywhere. Even my kids are not going to school. Tab chodo na school, hum aise padh lenge.
Makes sense.
Yeah, habitual fit na.
वही जो पॉइंट हमने पहले डिस्कस करा कि इंडस्ट्री डेवलप हो रही है तो चीजें भी डेवलप हो रही है, लेकिन वो जो टाइम है वो बेसिकली ग्रेटफुल है. सो माय लास्ट क्वेश्चन, एंड यस सर,
नो आई वाज जस्ट सेइंग दैट पीपल हैव टू चेंज द मेंटालिटी एज वेल, दैट बच्चों को फोन नहीं देना. अभी बच्चों को फोन दोगे नहीं तो कहां से आएगा? यू हैव टू ट्रीट इक्वल, एंड गवर्नमेंट आल्सो हैज टू फोकस ऑन द कनेक्टिविटी इशू. कहां का गांव में अभी भी इंटरनेट नहीं है, तो एवरीथिंग दे हैव टू वर्क ऑन.
एवरी इंडस्ट्री, एवरी फील्ड इज गेट अफेक्टेड बाय कोविड, बट जैसे जैसे कोविड इंक्रीज हुआ है तो लोग उस चीज को एविचुअल हो चुके हैं कि उस चीज को कैसे सॉल्व करना है. एजुकेशन हो गया, हेल्थ हो गया. यस सर. सो बेसिकली कंक्लूजन देते हुए सर, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव अ यू कैन व्हाट यू कैन एडवाइस यू कैन गिव टू द स्टूडेंट हु आर करंटली स्टार्टिंग देयर करियर or moving toward this e-learning or skill-based platform, what will be your advice you should give as a conclusion of this interview?
To the students, advice, so aajkal ke students ko pasand nahi aati hai. It's normally, but yes, I can suggest something. The time is very fast. Nowadays, like पहले जब हम स्कूल ज्वाइन किए थे तो शायद 5 साल या 6 साल के बाद मुझे आज भी याद है. When my father wanted me to admit in school, my grandmother said, no, अभी बच्चों को खेलने दे. Now the time is very much fast. Okay, अभी 3 साल के बच्चे को स्कूल में डाल दिया जाता है and he is speaking English as well. 5 साल के बच्चे ऑनलाइन
कोडिंग कर रहे हैं.
So you have to be fast. Fast, yes, you have to be fast, but you have to be focused also. Okay, and everyone has some talent. Like I'm not good in academics. It's not that you are not good. You have some other talent. So take it positive, identify your talent, and work on it. Second thing, do not completely 100% rely on the things what you are getting on over internet, because internet is a sea, and you have to ask if you want to search something, it will take months or years. So that is why we are here. If I said that you have to do this and go to this link, it means I have already searched everything for you. I have done all the exercise, and this is the conclusion for you. So always seek for the guidance of a trainer and then go ahead. And another thing, competition. Again, you have to face the competition. In this time, we are facing the competition. When the students are coming out from the industry, they have to face a lot of competition. So they should have something which others don't have. They have to identify the quality. Like, I'm a graphic designer, I'm an animator. So there are hundreds of people. So the company asks, why should I select you? Sir, graphic designing animation is a very common thing, I know. But I do augmented reality also. I have knowledge of programming also. I know game design also. So if you get this kind of work, I can do that also, which 99% students don't know. Okay. So when you got a job, always search for new talent. Okay, what is coming? You have to keep updating. Okay, after 2 months, this new software is working. Okay, if you are into animation, and I always keep searching. Okay, I started with CSMax, then Maya is there, the Blender is there. Now Houdini is also there. So you keep identifying the new things and start working on it. Get it trained. If you can afford a trainer, or if you can get online training from anywhere, but you have to be updated to sustain in this system. Okay, this is the only thing. And when you say that, yes, I know everything, it means you are stopped now. You don't have anything. So be learner. Still we are learning. I'm still learning. Before your session, also I was studying something, and after the session, again, I will study something. Okay. So be a learner, always learn. And then only, this is the only way to sustain in this competition. And there is no shortcut of success. You have to work hard. That's the only thing.
So you should be a multitasker, and you should be also learning everything and every day, basically.
Nowadays, multitasker is, because see, I have worked in several industries, and I was dominating all the employees. I was dominating, why? Because I was having something, one extra additional knowledge which they don't. And that was the only reason for dominating them. So you should have that knowledge. Okay, you can identify in your staff, okay, this is good in this, this is good in this, this is good in this. Okay, so if you have to make your own place, if you have to make your own importance, you have to. That's
okay. Okay, so thank you so much, sir. It was a great session with you. And I think after seeing this interview, a lot of students, not from specifically animation, VFX, but many other departments, students will also get inspired from you. Thank you so much, sir, for being a part of this.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.